YouTube channel. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you what scum-bling is. Have you ever heard of it? Are you curious? Well, we're going to be painting a sunflower, and I'm going to show you how to paint this sunflower using a technique called scum-bling. We're going to be using acrylic paints. So stick around, I'll be right back. Okay, now we're ready to get started. So now that I've got all that ready, I've got my paint can. I'm going to be using these three brushes. This is a 3/4 inch flat. You can use any flat brush. This is a 10 inch Phillips brush. And this is just a rough, hard bristle, stiff brush. So if you don't have any of these kind of paints, you can use whatever kind of acrylic paints you have at hand within these color ranges, and it'll be beautiful. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to wet my big brush, and I'm going to give it a little pat, and then I'm going to come in and I'm going to put the sky in. So I'm going to get a little bit of this blue and a little bit of the ultramarine blue. Going to add a touch more water to it, and I'm going to just bring it across the top of the canvas. Going back and forth, gliding gently. I'm going to get more of this blue, the cerulean blue. I'm just going to work that in. And now I'm going to start getting into a lot of white. Get some my brush wet. And I'm just going to continue all the way down to the bottom of the canvas, continually picking up more white. Occasionally adding a little bit more water. Now I'm going to rinse my brush off really well, and I'm just going to set this brush aside. And we're going to let the canvas dry, so I'll be back in a second, and we'll get ready to start our sunflower. Okay, so my canvas is just about dry. It's got a couple little wet spots, but that's okay for what we're going to do now. I am going to be using a round brush now to just kind of outline where my petals are going to be. So I'm going to get that brush wet, give it a little tap, and I'm going to roll this brush in some yellow paint. I'm going to come back and get some water and add that to it. And I just want it to be kind of thin, just to kind of help me map out where my flower is going to be. So I think I'm going to have a stem coming from here. So this is just really light. And then I'm going to have a petal here. Maybe one that comes here. And some of my petals are going to overlap other petals and come in front of them. And then I'll have some petals that are kind of behind. So I'll come in between the petals that I have, and I'll put some that are back behind. Now that I've done that, I'm going to mix up some black paint. So let me get my palette knife. I'm just going to get some ultramarine blue, some red, and some of this darker green. Use this for our darker color. So I'm going to take my round brush now and get some of this. Add a little water to it and roll it. And I'm just going to define where my center of my flower is going to be. And I'm going to have just kind of little wiggly edges coming around. And then I'm also going to come up right in the very center and just put a circle here. And if you have trouble doing circles, a great way to remember is to do a smile and then do a frown. So I'm going to clean that brush off now. Now that I have that set, I'm going to get my Filbert's brush and I'm going to get it wet. And I'm just going to get some of this yellow on here. And I'm going to pick up a little bit of this darker green. And now I'm going to add a touch of this black. And I'm just going to come into the areas that are going to be darker. So back in here, maybe alongside of some of these, it'll definitely be darker underneath here. We're just kind of putting the under layer coat on. So we don't have to worry about it being all completely smoothed out. I'm going to get a little bit more water. Some of these tips. Maybe right along at the very base. I'll just go around and put a little dark area around there. This section right over here too. And maybe this guy. Now while that's drying, because I don't want to put the other color on yet, I want to let that dry first. I'm going to come into the center and I'm going to put a nice base coat. Let's see what happens when we add a little bit of yellow to this. going to come in now, and I'm just going to fill this whole center in, except for that very center. We're gonna let that dry too now. But before we start letting that dry, I'm going to come in with this brush now. And I'm going to just kind of dip it in here. And the yellow. And I'm just gonna give this some taps. And then I'm going to take that same brush and I'm going to get some more yellow and I'm just going to tap it in the center. Now I'm going to kind of let that dry. I'm going to rinse my brush off. I'm going to get my flat brush and I'm going to get it wet. I'm going to get some of this dark green some of this blue and red right along in here. Oops, a little bit more of that. I want to come down this one side right there. That should be good. And I'll give my brush a rinse. Now I'm going to get some of this phthalo green and light green and come down in here. Thank you. We need to let all of this dry really well, and we'll come in and do some magic with some scumbling. So, I'll see you in a second. I'm ready now to start applying some of my yellow to the petals. So I'm going to get my big flat brush, and I'm just going to pick up some of this yellow. And yellow is a translucent color by itself, which means you can see through it. So we're just going to come over all of our petals, making sure to define where they are. And I'm not using really thick paint. I'm just adding a little water to this. Coming along an edge, I can come along like this, and it actually helps show off that edge with a little bit of a line. Same thing here, we've got a little line here. Just gonna kind of let the paint be a little bit thicker right there. We're still just kind of constructing it in the sense that we don't have to worry about all the fine details right now. We'll wrap up fine details when we're done getting everything on. Going to give my brush a rinse. I want to get my palette knife and I want to mix up some black with some blue, some red, and some yellow. Equal parts of all three. My palette knife off, and I want to mix up a golden color. So hang on a second here, and let me take a break for a minute. I'll be back in 1 second. Okay, so I'm going to mix up some red and some yellow. My palette knife off. And I'm just going to now get my little stubby brush again, and I want to tap that in there and maybe touch it to a little bit of yellow, and just along some of this, I want to put brighter pops . Give that brush a rinse. Now I'm going to take it and I'm going to just put it in the yellow by itself, and along the outer edge of the inside, I'm going to put little taps with yellow. I'm going to take my Filbert's brush and get a little tiny bit of this black, not real thick, and I'm going to come right into the center of this. Just make that a little pop darker. Let's kind of blend this a little bit more just by doing a little bit more tapping here. Some of this darker color and just put some more pops of that in there. Smooth that one out. Okay. down here on the stem, we're going to put a little bit of scum-bling on there. We're going to get a little bit of yellow, and we're going to just run it along the bottom. This is scum-bling when you're going over another color with a really thin shade, a thin coat of paint. And I'm just going to put it along this lower part. And now we have to let this all dry again, and then we'll get to our final magic with more scum-bling. Be back in 1 second. Okay, now we're ready to start putting on some of our other layers of scum-bling. And I did just put on some carbon black on my palette. I added that to my palette. So most of this is dry. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my big flat brush now, and I'm going to come up here and I'm going to get some of this orange that I made. I think I want it a little bit lighter. Okay, I just want it to have a nice little tint, nice golden color, and I'm going to add some water to that. And I'm going to come in from the center. Actually, I think we want a little bit more red. And I'm just putting a thin layer. Come in down here too. And maybe some of them it'll come up just a little bit more in some spots. Now I'm going to rinse my brush. I'm going to get my Phillips brush. I'm going to get a little bit of this carbon black. Just a little bit. I want to come right up under here. Just add a little peek of that. Same thing. Right in here. Let me blend that out a little bit. I'm just softly touching to blend this out. Put a little bit right down in there. Same thing over here. Now I'm going to get myself some more cadmium yellow. Using my Phillips brush. Oh, got to make sure I rinse this out. Definitely want to put a little bit more pops here and there with the yellow. That leaf comes, or that petal comes in front of those there, so I definitely want to have a nice little pop right here of yellow. Same thing right here. This little edge. I'm going to rinse my brush off now, and I'm going to come in with my filberts and get some more of this carbon black. I just want to come in to the center. Let me rinse. I just want a little bit. Just kind of tapping and pulling up from the center. Little bit more of this now, and I'm just going to come along that lower edge again. gonna pull up a little bit on it. Let some of that darker color come up into the center of the petal. Get a couple more back in here. Let's get a little bit of yellow on there. I think I'm going to come in with a little bit more yellow, and I'm going to bring it with some white. Just going to give this some light taps around that outer edge. Now we're going to take this. I want to wipe it kind of, I want to get it a little bit dry. Okay, let me get some yellow and white. Yellow, and I'm going to do the same thing out here, but I'm going to try to be very careful. Just want to pick up some little spots. And I'm going to pick up some of this black. Well, let me rinse my brush. Get some of this black on here and just along the bottom. I want to make it a little bit darker. And right along in here. Maybe a little bit more. Now I'm going to put a little bit more pop of yellow right down here. That's scumbling. I just scumbled a little layer over top. I'm going to get some of this. I'm going to scumble some of that right here. And I can come in now in just a few little places, and I can put a little thin layer of this cerulean blue just nice little pops, not everywhere, just in a few spots. I'm going to let it dry one more time, and when we come back, we're going to finish it up. So, I'll see you in 1 second. So now to finish this up, I got myself some fresh water, so you might need some too, and I'm going to get a little bit of white here, really thin, and I'm going to scumble some white in some areas. Just so it has a couple little spots. Let me get a little bit more. Maybe we'll going to put one more little layer of yellow right here. And I think I want to come in and just put a little bit more of this carbon black. Some little finishing touches to a couple of these ends. I'm going to take a little bit of this carbon black with some of this with my round brush, and I'm just going to come in. Maybe that has a little point on it. Maybe this one does too. Like a little part of it bent under. Maybe some will have just a little pop of light. Some white on there, and then I'm gonna blend it out. I rinsed my brush off, and I'm just gonna pull this down. I'm gonna leave that little tip of bright color, but I'm just pulling down. And I think that'll do it. That's a look at Scum-bling. Hey, did you learn anything new today? Let me know in the comments below if you did. I would love to know that you are learning something that I'm showing you. After all, I'm doing these tutorials for you. Also, if you've enjoyed watching what you've watched, like and subscribe and hit that old bell button. That way you'll get notified when I post new videos. So, until I see you again, happy painting.